sound.
So do they start with some questions or tell me when to start? Good evening. My name is Christopher Arvind. I'm the national president of Roundtable India. I'd just like to give you a small introduction about Roundtable. Roundtable is an organization of young men under the age of 40. This is a worldwide organization, started in Great Britain in the year 1927, came to India in the year 1958. Since then, this organization has grown leaps and bounds throughout India. Today, we have 320 chapters or tables, as we call, across the length and breadth in Tier 1 cities, Tier 2, Tier 3 cities. As an organization, we constitute of people from different backgrounds, different walks of lives. We have working professionals, architects, doctors. We have businessmen, entrepreneurs, various professionals, all under the age of 40. And what unites us, binds us, and brings us together is a keen interest to give back to the society what we have benefited, how abundantly we have been blessed as members of Roundtable. We look at this as a platform to give back to the society and to the nation. Though tables and have as chapters across the country have been involved in various community service and social service projects impacting in the areas of education, health and sanitation, we have chosen, however, one area as our major thrust area or focus area since the year 1997. We launched this campaign called Freedom Through Education. We thought we will pick one specific focus area and channel all our energies and resources into it and make a difference. And we identified that education is the key to breaking the cycle of poverty. Education is the key to bringing about a sense of discrimination between good and bad in terms of making citizens aware of their choices, and to look at our country as a developed nation 50 years, 20 years from now. We thought education is going to be the key. With this goal in mind, we decided to contribute towards infrastructure building of schools where children from economically challenged part of the society study. So these are in urban slums and these are in remote villages. These are also there in areas where there is no access, there are no roads. And we go identify these schools and look at what infrastructure they require to function as a better school. And classrooms was identified as a basic need where adequate classrooms were not there across the country in government school, government owned school, government aided school, NGO run schools. And we thought that is the basic thing. Children don't have a roof above their heads was an area of concern. So we started building classrooms. And today on average, we build 1.5 classrooms a day. We are proud to say that with the help of various partners and the governments and the corporates who have been funding us through their corporate social responsibility initiative, we have built close to 5,800 classrooms in the last 2 decades and impacted over 6.25 million children. That's about 62 lakh children. And the total value of projects that we have been involved just in terms of classrooms is estimated at about 165 crores in terms of Indian rupees. Now, over the last 5 years, we have also expanded from classrooms to looking at other components which will improve the quality of education. So we identified girls' toilet as one of a very important area because sanitation is a area of concern. The UNICEF says that, according to their survey, that 1 out of 5 girls typically in India drop out when they reach middle school because of lack of adequate sanitation facilities. So we have been building girls' toilets. We have been providing sanitary napkin vending machines, incinerators. We've also started providing schools with science labs, better play facilities, which is also equally important, playgrounds, play equipments, libraries, computer labs, and even today we are looking at smart classrooms in many schools where the schools have already adopted to new technology.
Okay, sir.
Good evening, friends. As the National President has just recently updated about what Roundtable India and Roundtable International is, Roundtable India is broadly segregated into 16 different chapters, 16 different areas, and we are a part of Area 9. We form Area 9. Area 9, we have cities like Hyderabad, we have Visakhapatnam, we have Vijayawada, and we have Guntur as of now. So collectively in this whole year, we have been able to construct more than 100 classrooms in Area 9 itself. That is all the three cities put together. And more than 30 toilet blocks, especially for the girl child, is what we have done. Other than that, the other focus what we are there, where we are creating digital classrooms for the children with the help of our sponsors, PNG. We are doing a lot of events to create awareness, to create publicity in the hearts of the public, so that they know what Roundtable India is doing. It is a thankless job, and we request the people to come forward and help us in the endeavors what we are doing further on. Thank you so much.